jointly organised by the government of the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region and the Hong Kong Trade Development Council, the sixth edition of the Belt and Road Summit opened with the policy dialogue session. Echoing this year's theme of driving growth through fostering regional and international trade, business and government leaders shared their insights on how multilateral cooperation along the Belt and Road can sustain global economic growth amid the pandemic.
That multilateralism and international cooperation are important more than ever, especially since the world is now getting itself vaccinated. Like one said, no country is safe until all countries are safe.
I am certain that the Belt and Road Initiative and regional as well as multilateral arrangements should complement each other. While we hope this pandemic can soon be over, let us embrace this new normal and welcome the multilateral partnership along the Belt and Road Initiative.
For the Philippines, it is important, therefore, to support initiatives that keep markets open and ensure the unhampered flow of essential goods and services by reducing unnecessary trade measures. It may be useful for those part of the Belt and Road Initiative to consider a similar arrangement with ASEAN.
As such, I encourage business leaders and investors from the Belt and Road partners nations to explore the many new economic opportunities here in the UAE market.
Individual infrastructure projects and plans were also highlighted to showcase the benefits brought by the Belt and Road Initiative to different regions around the world.
One of the flagship projects under the BRI that the government of Thailand has given high priority is the Thai-Chinese high-speed rail network. Once completed, the Thai railway line will span across Thailand and connect Vientiane in Lao PDR and Kunming in China.
Singapore is also collaborating with China to facilitate companies from both countries to work together in third-party markets under the Belt Road Initiative. The progress has not been easy due to the impact of COVID-19, but Singapore and China will continue to grow our cooperation.
We will work on creating greater linkage and enhancing synergy between the Master Plan of ASEAN Connectivity 2025 and Belt and Road Initiative in to contribute to the ASEAN connectivity agenda.
I'm encouraged to note that the expansion in terms of multimodal connectivity have assisted many countries seize the opportunities through BRI to benefit from supply chain relocations in the form of establishment of assembly centers.
As the world economy enters a new phase of cooperation under the pandemic, this year's virtual edition of the Belt and Road Summit continued to connect policymakers and business leaders across the region to explore opportunities arising from the Belt and Road Initiative and Guangdong-Hong Kong-Macau Greater Bay Area development.